Hi there. Today I'm showing you how to do vector calculations on the fx-991EX Classwiz scientific calculator. And I'm using the emulator, but all the steps would be the same if you had the handheld. So this is a menu operated calculator. So you see your menu options here, and you can, you know, scroll through the menu by clicking the arrows. So I'm going to this vector one, so you can see it looks like vectors, so that makes sense. Or you can just push 5, but once you get here, hit equals to actually enter it. The first thing you're asked to do is to define your vectors, so give your components of your vector. So notice you can enter up to 4 vectors. I'm just going to do 2 at this moment. So to do that, let's define vector A. So I'm going to choose one. It's going to ask me what the dimensions are. So notice you can have 2 or 3 dimensional vectors. We're just going to do a 2-1 now. So I'm going to enter 2 to enter my dimensions. And I have some numbers in there now, but I'm going to change this. So let's make it -7. So after you enter a component, you're gonna hit equals to set it. So now it's set, and I'm gonna hit option, which will get me back to my vector menu. And I want to define a second vector, so I'm gonna hit 1, and now I want to define vector B, also a 2 dimension, and let's make it have 3 and 16. And so now when I'm done entering, I'm going to hit options and it brings me back. So what can we do now? Well, we could edit the vectors we just entered if we wanted to change them, but I really kind of interested in vector calculations. I'm going to arrow down here so that you can see there's other things you can do, but we're going to do vector calculations. So 3. And so once I hit it, it says, okay, we're ready for you to do some calculations. So I need to get the vector names in there. So you're always going to go back to option. And now you see that there's some options to select the vectors you want. So remember, we've only defined vector A and vector B. So let's say I want to add them. So I'm going to choose 3. That puts vector A here. Now I'm going to do the type of calculation I want. So I want an addition. And I'm going to then hit option again. So option always gets you back to this little menu. And I'm going to choose vector B to add. And once I have them, I'm going to hit equals. And here is the solution, the vector answer to that calculation that I just did. What if I wanted to do a different type of calculation? So let's do 3. So there's my vector again. And this time let's do subtraction. So always go back with the option. So let's subtract vector B and equal. So now there's my vector answer. So very easy to do calculations. What if I wanted to do, so let's hit option to get us back. What if I wanted to do vector scalar multiplication? I could, again, choose a vector and multiply it by a scalar, which is going to result in 5 times each component. So very easy to do the type of calculations you're looking for. And you can even go, let's go back to options. So notice as I arrow down, I have some more. It'll show me the last answer that I got for my calculation, but I can also do the dot product. So let's choose, let's go back up here. Let's do the dot product of vector A. So we're going to go 3 to get vector A in here, and then option, arrow down, choose 2 for dot product, and now option again to go back and choose vector B, so 4. And when you hit equal, this is now the dot product of those two vectors. You can also do the angle between the vectors. So let's, how do we do that? So let's go arrow down and choose our angle. So we're going to choose this 3 angle. So notice it comes up with what vectors do you want. So to get the name of the vectors, option, I want vector A. And so there's vector A, and I'm going to use a comma. So the comma right here is in yellow. You'll see it above the parentheses. So I'm going to hit shift, comma, and now I want to put vector B in there. So I'm going to hit option, choose 4 to get vector B, and then I'm going to close my parentheses. So this is how you get the angle between vectors, so vector A, vector B in this case. So when you hit equal, it's going to give you that measure of that angle that is between those two vectors. So that's simple operations with vectors. Have fun exploring that.